to the first cabinet of the new municipal year. Thank you for attending. So let's go straight into item one, members' code of conduct, declarations of interest. Any cabinet members have any interest they wish to declare?
No.
No? Okay, great, thank you. Minutes, minutes of the last meeting. Can we agree that I sign them as a true record? Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Great. Thank you very much. Right, so we've got, that takes us into leaders' update. Item three, executive key decisions taken under delegated powers. We've got one decision to note. Can we note that key decision? Agreed? Okay, thank you. So moving on to item four. Strategic priorities for 2018-19. I'll just introduce this paper and then I'll ask if any of the cabinet members wish to enlarge on any of the strategic priorities. Can I just say clearly I'm pleased that the administration is continuing. We have a positive outcome from the local elections, and I'm pleased that Labour is still taking the authority forward. I think that's a vote of confidence in the job that we've been doing. So I want to pay a tribute to Cabinet members, the hard work they've done, particularly during the previous municipal year. In terms of the priorities for the next municipal year, obviously they're listed in briefly in the paper, but just to say a little bit more about these five areas. I think the first thing to say is that we are clearly moving ahead with our 2020 plan and our 20 pledges. We said when we were elected that we would focus relentlessly on meeting our 20 pledges. I believe that we are well on the way to doing that. We're coming into the fourth year of the five-year plan that we agreed in 2015. A lot has been done, but I'm very much looking forward to delivering on a whole range of areas, and they're kind of summarised in these five headings. So this must enable us to deliver on those 20 pledges, which I believe it does. Just very briefly in terms of the areas that have been highlighted, the first one, getting the basics right. I think we pride ourselves in having a really good quality environment in Wirral. Wirral's a wonderful place to live, work, invest and enjoy, and I think it's incumbent upon us to ensure sort of really key feature of the Wirral continues, and therefore we need to ensure that we get those key services right, particularly around the street scene, the environment, protecting vulnerable people, etc. We will relentlessly focus on those key issues. So I'm pleased, for example, that we've got funding to replace every street light in the borough. That's a really important statement of something that residents feel very strongly about, quite rightly. We will continue with our zero tolerance of littering and dog fouling. I make no apology for having a hard line on that. And also tackling antisocial behaviour. We know that's a key concern of many of our residents, and I'm very pleased as part of our the new cabinet appointments, Paul Stuart's joined us as the cabinet member for Law and Order to focus particularly on that issue that is a key priority with residents in all parts of the borough. So I think a focus on getting the basics right is absolutely important, and we will do that. Secondly, jobs and growth. So we're in the process of establishing the Wirral Growth Company. We've talked about this many times before around this cabinet table. We had a very effective launch of the Wirral Met College campus not so long ago. We've identified our preferred partner, Muse, All the pieces are being put in place to get that off the ground. Very shortly we will come forward with the key regeneration areas that we know in the borough around those five key areas: Birkenhead, Seacombe, Brighton, Bennington, Morton, phase one, and some exciting plans which we will consult with residents and businesses about. And for me, you know, it's about spades in the ground. We need to actually deliver on that very quickly, which will be important in terms of bringing new jobs and new investment into the borough, and also a vital source of new income to the council to address the financial challenges we've got. And obviously Andy Davies is taking the lead on that agenda. So very important agenda around jobs and growth. Thirdly, children's services. So we all know that we've got some challenges around ensuring that we move very rapidly to an excellent service for particularly our vulnerable children. We've got a really, I think, robust improvement plan in place, which we're making good progress on. That will be accelerated next year, and obviously the Burmese leadership, and we've got a new director in Paul Boyce. I'm very confident that we will move rapidly to a very high performing service on children's services. Fourthly, local plan and housing. So we have some challenging housing targets that we need to meet, which George is taking the lead on, George Davies. We need to complete our local plan. That's a must-do priority. And clearly, you know, our restate, our focus will be on bringing forward, in the first instance, as many brownfield sites as we can to develop on, because that keeps pressure off the green belt that we all cherish and want to protect as far as we can. So that will be a big priority for the next year. And then lastly, but by no means least, leisure and culture review. So we've obviously over the last year been doing a big piece of work around how we make our leisure facilities more sustainable financially, and Phil Brightmore is taking the lead on making sure that is delivered. And I've been impressed speaking to Phil just how much kind of work he's done already in the few weeks that he's had this brief for. So very briefly, those are the five kind of strategic priorities. Can I just say a little bit in closing before I bring the cabinet members in about the overall financial context, because underpinning all of this is the ongoing challenge we have of a government who is still hell-bent on austerity, which I think is completely the wrong course nationally, but we have to deal with that situation, and we have to make sure that the Wirral pound goes as far as we can. And this is not just said this many times, this is not just about what the council can do, it's about the Wirral partners and the Wirral pound generally. So it's our partners in health, police, fire, all of the key agencies. How can we collectively make sure that we deliver more for less? I think that's the big challenge going forward. But the next 12 months, again, will be another a year where we'll have to make significant savings. So we need to continue our focus on being more innovative, being more creative. The whole agenda around new models of delivery, I think, is even more important that we get that right. Leisure is an example of how we might do that. But we need to do it across the board as well, and bring in new income for streams for the council. That's why the work of the growth company is really important. That's why it's important we get the housing developments away, because you know, we've all seen the figures: 250 million of our budget cut in the last 8 years, and we need to replace that with new funding. Because we know that by 2021, the revenue support grant will disappear completely. Now, the government's doing a funding review. I hope they will change tack and introduce a local government finance system that does not penalise areas like Wirral and other areas in the north with high levels of deprivation. But let's, you know, the jury's out. Let's see what they come back with. But what I do know, and I want to avoid, and I've said this many times, and I'll say it again this morning, you know, we cannot allow ourselves to be in the position of Tory control of Northamptonshire County Council, which has literally gone bust, gone bankrupt because it's not planned for the future, and we've got central government commissioners running that authority. So we need to make even faster progress around how we're going to replace that money which the Conservatives have cut from our budget over the last 8 years, and further cuts to be made over the next 2 or 3 years. So the work that Janette's doing around finance, resources, income generation is important, but equally important is delivery, and also but making sure that we deliver based on our kind of Labour principles. So therefore, you know, the work of the growth company, it's really important we have that social value element to that work. So the hiring local, buying local dimension is absolutely key, because we need to make sure that our residents, particularly in the more deprived areas, benefit from that. So our principles around social justice and fairness and equality have got to be like a golden thread that runs through all of our policies. I think that's really important to emphasise that. So really, that's all what I wanted to say about the strategic priorities. Can I invite any cabinet members to add to that, Matthew?
Thank you, Phil. And I think I would agree with those priorities. I think the thing that strikes me is the need to get the basics right. How difficult that is in challenging financial circumstances. As you said, we've lost £250 million. That's enormous. And a lot of this is down to fundamentally unfair structuring of how local government's financed. We've got quite substantial bills for adult social care and children's social services, and it's completely right that we get those things right, and it's important that they are priorities as you study. But I've always been struck by that adage that about 80% of the money goes on about 10% of the people. And if the government recognised our higher need for vulnerable children, perhaps they'd fund that directly, rather than saying, well, you just take it out of the common pot. Because I think we penalise rural residents for the need of others, which is not good enough. I'm struck by the £45 billion that we need to remove this year. And I know that the entire portfolio of the environment would be swallowed up with that £45 million, and we'd still have to save more. And that is an incredibly difficult challenge, which is why I'm really grateful that between all of us, clearly, but I know George and George Davies and Angela Davis, we've got those priorities to bring some money in. And I'm sure you echo this, but the question and the answer, this is a challenge for every rural citizen. So if anybody has any ideas on how we can save money or should bring money in to fund these services, we've got to hear from them. Thank you.
The one thing that astounds me with the way this government are continuing to on the path of austerity and continuing to take money away is that they haven't, the penny doesn't seem to have dropped with them yet. That keeping people in poverty is a very expensive thing to do. People who are living in poverty are usually sicker. They need more health, they need more services. So I can't understand why they're continuing along the line. And for us as a council, it provides us with more and more and more problems. It makes it more and more difficult for us to provide the services that we have to the residents of the world. But the world is a fabulous place to live. It's one of the most beautiful parts of the country, I think. And I think we're doing the very best we can in very, very difficult situations. But I think somebody needs to say to Ms. May, poverty costs, and the sooner they realise that, the better. If they started giving us more money so we could look after our residents better, it would cost the government less. So I think that message needs to be drilled home. But I will go on to say that I think Wirral's a fabulous place to live, and we'll carry on doing our best. But the sooner we get rid of this government, the better.
Okay, Angie and then Phil and then Chris. Okay, Angie.
Okay, now I just wanted to say I kind of fully endorse these five you know, strategic priorities, and we know, don't we, by kind of speaking, you know, to people around the bar when we're out on the doorstep, that it's these real tangible things that, you know, that matter to people. You know, we're about to embark on this huge regeneration programme, you know, across the whole of Wirral, which is really, really exciting. It's going to mean real things to real people, you know, new jobs, for our young people, apprenticeships. It's also going to be new homes for people and new businesses. It's going to help some of our big businesses, but it's also going to help a lot of our small businesses as well. And it's kind of those things really that we are going to be judged on. And right, Phil, it would be easy, wouldn't it, in the face of kind of ongoing Tory austerity, you know, and the savage cuts to throw in the towel. But that's not who we're about, is it? You know, we're not about that. So yeah, I fully endorse these five.
Strategic
priority.
Great, thanks Andrew. Phil, and then Chris.
Thanks, Phil. I've been a councillor for 5 years, and every year I've been asked to make massive cuts from this council's budget. I cannot believe now, in my fifth year, we've been asked to make a third for 45 million. I think it's an absolute disgrace. I think it's astonishing, and I agree. Like Matthew, if we were to take 45 million from this budget, everything which I cover would be removed, and then we'd still be asking for more. I don't consider myself a camp member for leisure and recreation. I consider myself a camp member for saving our libraries, our leisure centres, our parks and our gardens from this government. And it's something I'm determined to do.
Thank you, Phil. I think the social justice element, you know, the way that we are trying to put our legal stamp on everything that we do, is really going to help our vulnerable residents. From a healthy little perspective, social care and health are working together to try and get every bit of value out of the little pound that we can to help our residents stay healthier and to help themselves. And I think, you know, as a council, we need to be there now to give the support for people to actually start helping themselves, perhaps a little bit more with a little bits of support that we can give. But I think, you know, the austerity we're living through, we're having a really difficult time. But if we can help residents to live better lives by giving them opportunities for jobs and apprenticeships, better housing, it's got to be good for everybody in the long run, as long as we work together and get on with it.
Thanks, Chris. Right, Janette.
Thanks, Phil. Yeah, I just wanted to endorse everything that everyone said here. I mean, it seems to me that austerity is a little bit like Brexit. It's only for little people. You know, we saw a lot of laws and applied for fascism last week, although we've got the biggest architects of Brexit. But we're here to mock the pieces of austerity. We're going to try our hardest. I think the electorate spoke loud and clear today. We voted for the Labour Party to run this council, the Labour councillors, and we've got very clear and distinct values from the opposition. We care about people, and we'll take them along with us. So I'm really wholeheartedly endorse this.
Thanks,
Joanne.
Stuart?
Thanks, Phil. I welcome us to focus on these five key priorities, in particular getting the basic choice. Certainly my inbox has been filled with concerns about street lighting and potholes over the past couple of years, particularly, you know, since the bad winter, which has obviously had a detrimental effect to our hours network. Very pleased in that we've managed to secure the funding to place every street light across the borough. That's very welcome. In terms of potholes, you know, it's a national problem. There's a £9.3 billion backup on pothole repairs, and even so, councils have managed to fix a pothole every 21 seconds across the country. Yes, we've got our funding challenges, but I think we need to step us to the place, but I shan't hold my breath. So I think that's something we need to have a very close look at over this coming municipal year. As everyone's aware, in the autumn we'll be getting greater control over our house contract. Developments will come back in with the council's control. We've already held a local market event, so we're inviting local contractors to come along, so we can narrow a bit for contracts, and, you know, so we can maximise their involvement in our new public housing maintenance arrangements and maximise the use of the rural bank.
Okay. George,
thanks very much today, Phil. I think a lot of my colleagues have said most of the things that I would have wanted to say, which you naturally would think, in particularly on the austerity measure that is still with us today. And I think it's absolutely appalling of this Tory government who have gone down this route, and the vulnerable people in particular, the Wirral, are experiencing some really hard times at this present moment in time. In terms of the council itself and where we are, if you look at what we've actually got in terms of funding, two departments, children's and adult social service, which are strategic departments that need to be there all the time, right, they take up £180 million of our money. We've got roughly around about £220, £230 million. So we can see it doesn't send a lot, or it doesn't give you a lot, for all the other departments that we're looking at over the time. The five policy agendas that I think that we've gone through this morning are ideal for what we're looking for. The bringing in the funding is now most important. But I think that from our point of view and from the press's point of view, is to get the message across to people that the problem that we have got is that problem about the funding. And that as a council, like every other council in the country, we're struggling. A lot of councils now are going to finish up this year very much like Northampton. And our job is to protect the people of Wirral from that, getting to that position. And that's what our job is to do. One of the things that we will do is by, as Phil rightly announced before, by bringing in extra funding for a new homes bonus, council tax on new houses, all the things that we have to do and will do to ensure that the people of Wirral are not left in any further vulnerable position by this horrible government.
Okay, thanks very much, folks. Okay, so that's obviously just a snapshot, really, if you like, of the priorities. We could have spent a lot more talking about each one of them individually, but I think that the overall message is austerity continues, but we're not going to use that as an excuse or as a reason why we shouldn't be ambitious for the people of Wirral and why we shouldn't do everything we can to bring in that additional income to enable us to continue delivering good quality services. You know, I think that is very much our focus, and also, you know, delivering everything against, a background of does it meet our social justice principles? And I think that's really important to emphasise. So, can I put you in the direction of the recommendations on page 4, paragraph 2. So, Cabinet are being recommended to reaffirm our support for the Wirral Plan and endorse the strategic priorities for 18-19 as set out in the report, and secondly, instructing relevant senior officers to work with Cabinet portfolio holders to develop the detailed plans required to deliver those strategic priorities. And clearly, we will report back to Cabinet at regular intervals on how we are performing against those 20 pledges and the 5 strategic priorities. So, is that seconded? Is that agreed? Okay, thanks very much. Okay, that takes us there on to item 5, which is the consent to legislation to enable devolution of the adult education budget. Bernie?
Thanks, Phil. The purpose of this report is to outline the process for agreeing the devolution order required to integrate the funds for the adult education budget into the devolution agreement for the academic year of 2019-2020. The adult education budget is administrated nationally by the Education Skills Funding Agency, and funds a very important section of the lifelong learning service for further education here with Wirral Met. This service is very important as it forms part of our commitment to bring to be able to bring help and education to all of our residents and to improve their life chances. The Combined Authority does not, at this present moment, have the legal power to allow the administration of the adult education budget, because it was not included within the order which created the role of the Metro Mayor. The delay in providing these powers has delayed the implementation of the order till 2019-2020. So to enable this order and the legal powers to be conferred on the Combined Authority, an order needs to be laid and agreed by in Parliament. This is part of the process needed. This agreement today is part of the process needed for creation the Combined Authority and being part of enabling the devolution agreement. So the final draft of this order will have been tabled at the end of May. The next part of this process now will be that we have to, all authorities right the way across the region will have to do exactly as we're doing today and agree for this order to go to Parliament. So that needs to be authorised by June, the mid-June 2018. So we have a small window to complete this process. So what I'm asking you to do is to agree the process. The recommendations are on page 10 of your papers today, or page 14 of the old papers, whichever ones you have. So if you look at the recommendations are cabinets to note the requirement of each Liverpool City Region local authority to provide consent for the draft legislation order to enable the transfer of adult education budget powers to the Combined Authority from the start of 2019-20's academic year. So this needs to be done by June 2018, and Cabinet to agree the delegated authority and the Chief Executive to provide consent to the final order on behalf of this Council. I'm a great believer in lifelong learning. It gives people a second chance, and people who've had no qualifications, it gives them a second chance to come in and gain the qualifications that they need to go on. And Wirral Met have been instrumental in going out and supporting people who may have fell through the cracks of education for one reason or another. So this is something that's close to my heart, and it's something that, along with everything else that we're doing with the growth company and providing jobs for people, it's given people another chance. So I think it's really, really important. So I would be very grateful if you'd support this today, and all the other authorities support it as well. So thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Bernie. I think, really, you know, just to reiterate what you said, this should have, government, central government should have made this power available to us last year. So they're a year behind. You know, we've expressed our concern about that, but better late than never. And, you know, the post-19 adult education budget is a key budget to enable us to enable those learners to contribute to some of the social and economic goals that we've been talking about this morning with the growth company and others. So really, really important. And I think it underlines the fact that, you know, just to reiterate why we entered into the devolution agreement in the first place in 2015, that these decisions are much better made by local representatives representing the people of the Liverpool City Region than a minister or a mandarin in Whitehall. That's why we're doing this. So it's important that we get this over the line, and I think we all want further powers and funding. Particularly, funding's got to go with the powers devolved from central government as quickly as possible. Difficult to get a dialogue with government at the moment because everybody seems to be totally obsessed with Brexit, but we will continue, and I know Steve Rotherham, as the Metro Mayor, is continuing to lobby ministers for further devolution. But this is an important element of that devolution deal that we agreed in 2015, so I think we just need to agree this. All the other local authorities are doing the same, and let's get this in place as quickly as we can now. So, see the recommendations in front of us. Can we agree those recommendations? Okay, is that seconded? Is that agreed? Thank you very much. Okay,
I've not been notified of any other urgent business, so that concludes the business of Cabinet. I close the meeting and thank you for your attendance. Thank you.